This next exercise involves planning routes on a subway system. This is a map of the subway system for my hometown of Boston. And we're going to have a representation of this map, and then we're going to be able to ask questions of what's the shortest path to get from A to B. Now I'm going to show you what I decided as the format for how I represent the subway line and the functions I want you to write. So I'm going to represent it as we call this function subway, which builds up a data structure and assigns that, we're going to assign it to the variable Boston. And the arguments to this function are a bunch of keyword arguments. Blue is the list of stations separated by spaces, just regular words separated by spaces. And the orange line, green line, red line, similar. Now, here's the signature for this function subway. It takes this double asterisk parameter name notation. If you haven't seen that before, what that means is that these are the keyword arguments. So two asterisks means everything that's left is going to be a keyword argument. I'm not going to tell you what they are. They can be anything. And collect them into this parameter called lines and make that be a dictionary. A dictionary where, in this case, the keys of the dictionary would be the strings blue, orange, green, and red. And the values of the dictionary would be these corresponding strings. So that's what lines is. Then you do whatever you want to lines and return the result. If you want, you could just return the lines dictionary as is. That would be fine. But if you did that, you'd probably need to do more complicated processing on the values later on. So you might want to do some of the processing up front and return some other type of data structure for subway because you're going to need it down here. So down here, we're going to write the ride function that says, how do we get from here to there? So here and there are going to be stops. For example, how do we get from Oak Grove to downtown station or stop? Those are just strings which represent the stops. The system, which in this case is defaults to Boston, the subway system that we previously defined. And you write your code there. And presumably, you're going to have some sort of call to a search function. You're going to need to define a successor function that'll be appropriate. And so you need to decide what's the representation you'll come up with for subway that will be useful to the successor function that you're going to use here. And then, just for fun, let's also write the function longest ride, which takes as input a subway system, such as Boston, and tells you what's the longest ride you can get from all the pairs of stations going from one to the other, what's the longest one. And I helped you out a little bit here by writing just a small number of test cases, and you can try that out. You can also write more test cases on your own.